All right, welcome to another edition of Cast It. This is for game 357422062 8, Anti-Mage versus Ember Spirit. So looking at the cast, we've got Slardar, Oct-Orc on the Radiant side, along with CMZ on the Tinker, Nine on the Anti-Mage, Claire on the Pangolier, and Icedal taking up the Abaddon. And then on the Dire side, we've got Salsin on the Lich, Walbris on the Ember Spirit, Wapak Poggy on the Storm Spirit, Otomo on the Spirit Breaker, and Hurricane Pike on the Necrophilus. I am, as always, General Jeevicus. Bear with me 2 seconds and we'll get the show under the road. On the road? On the road. You guys on the road. Let's go. All right, initial item pickups. Nothing too exciting there. Interesting lack of wards. Oh, there we go. They're coming in now. That's fine. It's going to be Spirit Breaker and Hurricane Pike who pick up those
My
wards there.
friends, this one is in the bag.
Well, Lich is feeling pretty confident. He's got five predictions in a row. Otomo with the early roam down here. Looks like we're gonna have three in this bottom lane, so could be an early rune debate gonna happen here. I'm gonna try and steal it maybe. We've got a smoke as well on the Spirit Breaker. This is
30 seconds
super
to
deep
battle.
though, by Orc-Orc, Oct-Orc. Super deep. Roaming it out. He thinks, yeah, we'll take this top rune. Kind of must give them some kind of information, I suppose, in regards to where. Oh dear. Warbis. I'm gonna spot out the Slardar. Slardar, though, he wants this rune. Pangolier gonna back him up. And down
Cast off
bottom
the
as well.
binds. We embark for battle.
Necrophos goes in onto Claire, but
Challenge
Claire will take that, thanks
accepted.
very much. Charge comes in. It's quite far away though. So nothing gonna happen there, nothing gonna happen here. So it was a one for one right across the board, Oct-Orc and CMZ. Oh no. Actually it was three bounty runes for the Radiant. And it will be a contested mid. Alrighty. What's going on? Oh, Slardar with the plays on the back line. And that'll be enough. He will go on his merry way. Oh, he's thinking about it. He's thinking, hello, surprise! Debated! I still don't think he has enough damage to kill him. Tower gonna come into play now. Mid lane, I hear lasers getting fired. Storm and Ember on the same team together. Only the Earth Brother missing. Or maybe there's another brother. Top lane, what you got going on? I mean, it's a nice. I mean, if you're Ember Spirit, you're super happy right now.
No,
Getting a solo lane versus the Pangolier.
First blood.
Oh, mid,
I accept this order
fighting,
on behalf of
Oct-Orc.
storms everywhere.
Oh, I see. They tried a rotation, but the dire rotation was better. Here comes CMZ, see if he can get something off the back of this. He has laser, decides not to use it. Maybe it's on cooldown. No, he had laser and rockets. Okay, I definitely think he could have got something done there. Maybe he just wasn't feeling it, you know? Okay, Pike, I suppose he's got a level in his aura. He does. Nine. Oh, wait, nine swapped with Claire, by the way. Interesting,
Denied.
very interesting.
Alms for the dead.
Well, Anti-Mage leading the last hits, 10 and 3 versus 9 and 4 of that Ember Spirit in the uncontested lane. I guess he's getting contested a little bit. Oh, the
Dire's
charge
middle
coming in,
tower
but
is under
they might
pressure.
get him here. Tinker's actually DC'd. The charge is from base. This guy's in trouble. What have we got though? We got no mana available for Abaddon. He's got 100 mana. He needs 115. He will regen, so he'll get that in about 10 seconds. More like 11. Slardar, plenty of mana. He could force feed. If things get hairy, he can force feed the mango to 9, and 9 could shield him, but there should be enough damage here now. One more. One more. Yep. Octork then. Gonna pick up that kill. Oh, the charge, I forgot about it. Yeah, there's no further confrontation gonna come off the back of that. Well, Pangolier, he's having a good time as well, mind you. Level 3, 6-0. Chains now. Regeneration. Oh, Slardar looking for Spirit Breaker. The two bouncers up and down this river. His health is a little low, but I don't think he needs to worry too much. I suppose he's going to build the Ring of Health first. He has it actually already in his stash. And he just gets that out, and then that deals with Necrophosis Aura for the main part. Charge into mid. Oh, CMZ having a bottle up. How's he going for his items? He's got a bottle, and it looks like he's going to get an urn next. Soul Ring, even. New Soul Ring pattern. Soul Ring, I guess. Let's have fight early. Bloodstone component. No, Wapak having a little go here. Needs his posse. Meanwhile, in the top lane, Pangolier. Ice Dolly gonna tango up, but he's in a real bad state right now. Here comes his buddy Slardar, and there will be a TP response as well. Chains though, in comes Abaddon, getting ready to shield your buddy. No shield coming out from Abaddon, doesn't have it yet. And it's Ember, actually, unbelievably, that's going to get caught here. He will get in behind the tower, just the ice armor coming out in the nick of time. Saiyasin's pathing choices there. Debating the men a little bit, but no response from any of the other lanes. Well, there's still fighting going on up here. A lot of resources moving around, leaving the anti-mage free to farm. Necrophos though, despite the mana burn available on the anti-mage, able to keep his ground. Presumably all the blink stacks are paying off. A little bit through the jungle here, there's no smoke though, but there's no wards either, so they won't see this coming. Oh, these guys are so low. Slardar only knew. If Slardar only knew, boys, it would have been the fish being the fisherman there. What a catch that would have been. Oh, Ice Doll stun gonna reveal the bad and find the Pangolier. It comes in, there's some chains. There'll also be some right click from Saracen from the range. Pops his fairy fire. Is it gonna be enough to get him out? I'm not sure it is. It will not be. Warbriss gets the final hit. Slardar and Abaddon thinking better than to join the fray. Here goes the charge out from Mr. Breaker. Oh, right in on top of CMZ. The stun from Slardar almost saves him though. And Wapak Pogi probably going to be in a lot of danger himself. Throws out some more damage and he is going to get a kill. One right click was all he needed, but just a little dance up on the high ground without any ward vision for the Radiant just meant he was able to line of sight him effectively. Nice little play. This ward getting pinged out immediately by CMZ. Free 100 gold. Oh no, no mana for this guy. He does have Soul Ring though, so not the worst situation. I mean, I think he dies instantly if he gets mana break there, right? Does he? No, he would have, yeah. Yeah, he would have, 100%. 400 damage. Is there a bonus to it? I don't think it's much if it is. Oh, it's only 0.6, so it would only be 300 damage. I see. I see, said the blind man. Well, Spirit Breaker getting in position. He should be able to double bash here. Possibly triple bash, depending on his position. Just waiting for his instructions. Abaddon has been sent to the high ground to go and have a little look up there. And immediately going to spot out the Spirit Breaker. So the charge is going to go bottom. Necrophos gets it called out to him. He is in behind the trees. It's not Necrophos, but Necrophos is down. Slardar now. Here comes Storm Spirit. He's going to chomp him up nice and quickly. He knows how weak he is. Only level 3 still. Shield comes through from Abaddon, and that might save his life. And Storm, with all the zips, might actually be in a bit of trouble himself. But Anti-Mage thinks better of it, decides to go back for the Storm Spirit. Some questionable play decisions being made here. Oh, but he goes back in. Is he gonna... Oh, he already used Mana Break. Okay. And Wobbris on the top lane. Gonna get a kill while all that's going off.
Dire's top tower needs some friends.
Same as you, Giant Hunter.
6-2 then. As we come out of this, you know, early, very early game.
Precious bounty.
It's not looking great for the Radiant. Oh, Necrophos, buddy, your time of being able to do that is over. Actually, he's fine. He's just going to walk it off. Maybe an Orb of Venom on Slardar would be pretty...
Refuse gold given.
Nice. Double stack camp. Going to get collected up by... Morbus. Whoa, here comes a charge on a Pangolier. Poor Pangolier off lane. He'll be fine though. He does get a TV response in from Oct Orc, and Pangolier is going back in. Ember's already in a little bit of trouble. Why not? Why not try for the gank? A little warning that Storm Spirit is missing. Here comes the march, but where's his charge going? Oh my god. Ball lightning in, stun, and pops the invis rune, and he's going to be fine. No sentry in mid lane for the Dire at the moment, just one for the Radiant. Regen rune top though, that's going to be pretty huge for whoever gets it. I don't think Tinker needs it, but it will allow and enable him to make some plays if he gets it. Oh, I'm going to get that spotted out. It's just going to see it get taken right in front of his eyes. Sad times. Let's switch it over to net worth.
Radiant are scanning for enemies.
Well, neck and neck then. The Ember and the Anti-Mage. Ember with a very slight advantage, two creeps or something. It's no big deal.
Top lane is missing.
Dink. Oh my god, big gank going up the ult from Saosin. Actually going to take down, or at least help take down, the Slardar. Now 9 runs for his life. Doesn't have that ult yet, but Anti-Mage is here with the big mana void. Gonna kill the Lich first. Now the Spirit Breaker is pretty weak as well, but he's just gonna take his kill all the way to the bank. Thank you very much. Very close to finishing up this Battle Fury now as well. 400 gold. His farm should accelerate significantly after that. our boy on the Ember Spirit. He's a little bit further away, but he does have the full... Well, they both have that. Okay. Yeah, Anti-Mage is much further ahead as far as progress is concerned. Hey, 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 Stan. He will pop his juicy goodness now. Try and get out of there. I'm gonna try for the body blocks. Storm Spirit missing call. Now top lane. Ember diving towers for this Pangolier without a care in the world.
tribute to my house.
Oh, the Battle Fury has completed and on its way to the Anti-Mage. Here we go. Here it comes, Luke. Dun 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 dun. Here comes the stun. Spirit Breaker's long chase. Crunch. On the backside. There's another Lich. Ult throwed out some damage. Poggy in trouble. Oh no, the ult goes down on Slardar though. Anti-Mage did not find any. Oh, he did. Did he find someone? I don't think he did. Maybe he found a Lich. Necrophos. Not in as much trouble as it looks like. Well, maybe he is. I was going to say he could cast a magic, but his Death Pulse was on cooldown and didn't have mana. Ghost Shroud on cooldown. Not enough mana for Death Pulse.
A soldier's fortune.
Alright, I like this item build from Ice Dolly. I'm not sure. Oh. In comes Walbris, the stun return from Slardar, but he's only level 5. He's getting burned down, and there's a little bit of burst to finish him. Walbris. So close to finishing up his Battle Fury. In comes the Pangolier. Stun locked, but burning chains will keep him in place. Spirit Breaker ready to charge at a moment's notice. Oh, hi Abaddon. Ult comes through, in comes. Oh, you didn't want that. He's still not level 6. Down goes Abaddon again. But Anti-Mage is here. Warbis doing quite a lot of damage. Dodged the missiles there, CMZ. Oh, he didn't get him. One more hit would have got Anti-Mage. And now Poggy in trouble himself. Ember Spirit got picked off as well, guys. That's pretty rough for the Dire. Excellent turn of events for the Radiant. I'm going to pick up 2k XP, 1.8k XP and 1.2k gold.
Dire's top tower is about to take the plunge.
So we got a double bracer building into Rod of Atos for Necrophos. Tinkerini does have his travels. He's looking to get his blink next. Is under attack. Just Trunks for the poor
middle tower is under pressure.
The poor Lich. He will get Glimmer Cape and a bracer for HPs though. Probably build that into something. Is this the new build up for Monkey King Bar? Is it? Well, Oct Orc gonna get charged. Supplies! Oh, in comes the ult. That's going to do a little bit of damage, but not much. And Ice Dolly going to get the stun on two. Looking for something to bounce on. Who found it? Ult comes through onto Slardar again. Down he goes. Rockets come through. Try to create some space. Here comes Ember with the remnant forward. Walbris looking for a target. Looking for any target. Nope. He wanted specifically the Tinker. Tinker will return. Indiscreet wave, fully manned up, ready to roll.
Dire's bottom tower is about to flounder.
Well, March out here should put paid to that particular push. He's just gonna march around the map. Oh, Spirit Breaker creeping to bottom.
Stupendous.
Well, if this is bad frames per second, guys, it is a tinker game. Just bear that in mind. Oh, chains, and the ult should be ready soon. They don't even need it. In comes the Ember. Utterly burns through Slardar, but CMZ rockets coming in, but he manages to dodge. Oh, down he goes though, and this is gonna be a triple kill. Well, dominating, two dominating streaks and a double kill for the Tinker. Yep. Well, that's rough. Is about to take the flood. Overconfidence on the side of the Dire. Not realizing that their edge wasn't quite there.
Dire's top tower is under attack. Dire's top tower has fallen.
Well, the Tinker's stopping any trades across the map, and this mid tower gonna get denied now as well.
What? Dire's middle tower was denied?
Dun, 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 dun. More creeping Tinker plays. Getting pinged out bottom, that's a double damage, was it? No. Yes, double damage on Poggy. And now, Necrophos is, he's in the jungle, he's trying to get some action, but it's a debate or something. Here comes the Anti-Mage, they bit off more than they could chew, and now Necrophos having to run, but in comes double damage, Storm Spirit, Anti-Mage, what a beautiful pick-off, they needed that badly. Ice Dolly gets slowed up. The laser actually burns up some of Poggy's health, and the March of the Machines is doing some more. In comes the ult from Lich. Only hits one, but it's enough. Ice Dolly is dead. CMZ looking for collateral on the backside, along with Slardar. The zip in. Down he goes. Frost blowing up. Double damage. Too much for the Radiant team. 3-0 being the result there. Nice lot if you can get it.
Radiant structures are fortified.
Well, looking deep. Actually, here comes the Pangolier, and Wobbrus just doesn't have the HP. Forced to Remnant out in shame. Oh, I see. Well, I'm gonna farm up a bit while his Battle Fury brings him back to health. I guess this is his plan. It's probably not gonna work too well if he does Ancients. Oh, bottom, what's going on here? Necrophos gets hit up. Laser comes through as well, and some rockets. He's in some serious deepness right now. Oh, and Ember comes in with like no health at all. A few rockets just from CMZ could finish the day for him. He did rearm. There's a rocket going out now. His shield actually will protect him. Damage shield from flame shield guard. Stun. Another laser. Remnants across. But he comes back into the stun. Actually brings himself back in. Gets the Necro on the back line with the arcane magic thingy-majig mana void. Bash. There's more. So, 3 of the Radiant go down for 0 of the Dire, an exact opposite of the situation previously.
Dire's bottom tower won't last long. Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
What's this? Dire fortified their structures?
Oh, am I getting lag? Are you serious?
Is about to flounder.
Oh, I am. Okay, bear with me 2 seconds, guys. I'll fix this. What is this? Sorry guys, some weird process running in the background, slowing everything down. No! Oh, rooted up on Pangolier, and in they come with the Necro ults to secure it. The rain of rockets comes out from Tinker, but it's not enough through the Flame Guard to finish them. Well, he did take plus 200 flame guard absorption and now plus one. Oh, hi. Octort goes toe to toe. I'll pull him back in with the vortex into remnant. Two remnants, three remnants. Rockets. More rockets. He's spotted up, so he should be fine. Probably more of an annoyance to the two of these guys. They do have healing recovery items. Wow, he has his ult this time. They start throwing damage at him, trying to keep him there. That's going to fully heal him up, but now the burn down comes. He has no HP, guys. He only has 1160 top lane. There will be a charge. It's on Anti-Mage. Quite good catch. He is going to the side shop. Here comes the charge. Boom, TP comes in from Slardar. Response. They're looking for the kill. This is bad. The rest of the Dire team are close by. Stun though. Oh, he tried for the ult. It wasn't enough though. Pangolier to the rescue, going to help out. Ember trying to get some damage done, but actually he's the one getting targeted. It was a debate. Down he goes. Ice Dolly with the rolls. Let's see him rolling. The Hayden in comes Storm Spirit though. And causing some hate of his own. No, Necro will be taken out. The fear, not there. Bogey, too weak still. Lich looking to sacrifice himself. No, Pogey, this was your time. Oh, but they do get Ice Doll. And now Pogey. Oh. Spirit Breaker returns to the fray, and the March of the Machines alone almost gobbles up the Lich, but Rocket Spam will do the job. It will find its...
Dire's middle tower is under pressure.
Target. Ulgris. What's he going to do? Slardar. Halfway to his blink dagger now. Urn finished up along with completed wand. Mechanism. Oh no, it's... Not sure. He will get Morbid Mask next. I think it's just so he can farm with the Mask of Madness.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Anti-Mage has his Manta style finished up. Necrophos has... Atos, and he is building himself Arcane Boots and a Lotus Orb. Hi! Zips in, a little bit of a chokehold. He's trying to so desperately to get away, but he doesn't know the charge is there. He tries for the stun, but Pogey expects it and waits. I understand why. Right.
Coin for me.
Gold for me.
Well, 26 minutes in, two net worth leaders are on the Radiant side. And then the Dire follow up. Only 4k advantage for the Radiant team though, with the Anti-Mage there. It's quite surprising. Oh, Baden finds Spirit Breaker. One little right click will be the end of it. Affirmative. No, scan will not find anything. They will ping out here though. Gonna spot a Baden. doing his rounds.
Dire's bottom tower won't last long. Dire's bottom tower.
27 minutes. Anti-Mage has found level 20. He's got himself a Vanguard and Uncontrollable Illusion. Using them to block camps on his own side of the jungle already. Nah, they'll be long gone. They will be long gone, Jeeficus. He will be much more careful, I'm sure. Let's go and see what's happening up here. Ice armor there in Zips. Oh, the ult from 9 goes off. They're waiting it out. It's been waited it out. In comes a stun. Bit one from Spirit Breaker in return. The rolling boulder is going wild and trying to remnant away, but the laser will find him and the Claire will get the final right click onto Ember. Gonna be happy to pick that kill up. Oh, Spirit Breaker needs to charge away to safety. Well, Ember Spirit down, there is a buyback, but that's a nice kill at this point in the game. Oh, rockets and everything. Blink forward into a Dagon. Now, Tinker gonna get focused. And Anti-Mage just blows them both up with the mana voids. And that's gonna be for sure. 100% for sure they get tier 3, possibly ranged racks. Oh, looking to fight instead.
Dire's top tower is about to take the plunge.
No, here comes Storm Spirit with the vortex. Anti-Mage gonna blink out. They haven't quite taken that tower yet. Are you joking me? Honestly, Anti-Mage. Honestly, Anti-Mage. Well, I guess this game is going to last a little bit longer, folks. Here comes the charge.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
He's smoked or invis right under the tower. It throws out the urn. He's actually doing significant damage. Remember, Spirit Breaker's level 13. Slardar's level 15. So he has a level advantage. And zips Storm Spirit. And that's down for Slardar. That's fine with the Vortex there. CMZ getting caught off guard as well as Jeeficus. And double kill for Foggy and two Bloodstone charges. Mega kill on the top lane. Wait, what? No, mega kill right there, dude. Anti-Mage just creeps in behind and boom! Hits him with a mana void. Game over. Nice. Nicely done.
Tis mine. Radiant's top tower is on the rocks. Radiant's top tower is under attack. Radiant's top tower just got sent to the bottom. Really tight, Hunter.
Really?
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
That's some siege. Those are all just illusions, remember. It's gonna burn the ult for the creep wave. Okay.
Denied their bottom tower.
Okay, a little bit of advancement up from the Radiant here. That's a big creep wave for Clear to Farm. And propel him towards yet another item. That's the Abyssal finished.
Ooh,
Abyssal. Should give him more lockdown. Spot the Storm Spirit out, but no catch for him. And it stack the Ancients for Anti-Mage. Nice. Nice, very considerate of them. The Dire, while they're retreating, they're not of the salt and of that destroy your enemies and sow salt in their fields. They're all about give them the farm, make them fat and slow, juicy. Bottom lane, Tinker continues the march of the machines. Oh, hi, are we going to go on? I think we are. Charge comes through. There's an Atos as well, going to pin him in place. Starts to get away, in comes Slardar with the three man crush though. And now a march of the machines while an image goes to work top, finishing that tower, and now going to work on the racks. So we'll have a little look at that fight. In comes the ult from Lich, a little bit better than last time. Blink out though. Oh, he is going to actually be caught and killed. And he chose to make work of the melee racks instead of the ranged racks, so this damage will heal up fairly quickly. Oh, you can't Hurricane Pike that, but Slardar, you can't face those guys. Utter destruction. He's actually gonna get out, are you serious? He gets him with his crush to save his own life, and now Storm Spirit just zips out. He just says, nope, I don't want to die for a Slardar. What a beautiful little play by Slardar there, getting the stun off just at the right time. Tinkerini continues to boost these lanes. Maybe he wants to get himself a Necro Book, you know?
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Oh, zipping and jiving and zipping and jiving. Eleven charges on this bloodstone. He will need to be careful.
Someone should help Dire's top barracks.
Yes, someone should help Dire's top barracks. Ah, oh, there you go. 400 damage done already. That's nice. It's nice, you know, it's nice. Here comes charge though, Tinker. Blinks away. Tries for the four staff. Crash. Boom, there it is, knocks him back, and in comes Storm Spirit to make sure he gets the juicy Bloodstone charges. Now, there's no way Tinker should have died there, you know. A pistol in a glimmer cape, followed up by Mana Void. Down he goes. Ember feeling a little bit of pressure as they go hunting for him in the trees. Spirit Breaker wants to protect. Oh, in comes the bash. AM? Are you do anything? No. Baden just too slow to shield him there. Fuck shield, he was just too slow to get it off, I think. Oh, and Anti-Mage is actually broken. Here's the ult from Necrophos. I like it. Nice protection. Now, they'll be in a bit of trouble here. I'm not sure they can face off so much against this lot. In comes the ult from Lich. Only hits on two, though, which is amazing. Oh, Baden. They know, buddy. All you had to do was hit him. All you had to do was turn and right-click him. Or hit yourself with the beam, dude. That probably kills you, actually. Maybe beat you on one health, I'm not sure. It's better than the other guy killing you though, right? Yes.
Radiant's middle tower can't handle this deluge. Radiant fortified their structures.
Well, Dire finally getting a bit of a stronger counter push on the way now. Beat one tower down. Fortification refreshed. Gonna use it early. Obviously, they'll get another one when this tower goes down. The trick is to assault this one and this one in the meantime. And then after that, you can take the tower down. That way, they never have fortification available. Zips in, this could be a nice fight, yep. If you want to watch it, Jeevicus, you should be faster. So what happened there? I don't know, let's have a quick look. Slardar died. No mini Vayron, I don't want to party right now. Gold change, 730 gold. 2,500 damage. It was over in seconds. Big fight here. Oh, Lich. On the backside, Pangolier getting work done. Throws out a swashbuckle, but Necrophos still tanky despite his nerfs. Abaddon has no ult, so he will fall, and that's going to be a 1 for naught trade. Stacking up on this 3 for naught trade overall for the Dire. Throws out, blinks forward, gets him with the chains, he is rooted, he has swashbuckle available. He will die, but clear. Oh, I thought he stunned him, he didn't. Mana Void will finish him. Level 25 on the Anti-Mage. In cruise mode at the moment, gonna get an Ags next. It's a curious, it's an interesting idea. Let's run some calculations here. So it gives him back the bash, okay. And oh, the Lich ult is really nice, actually. And the Necrophos is a bit rubbish. And the Vortex is pretty good. Yeah, okay. Some good, some bad. Some good, some bad. Not sure it's ideal. Oh, here we go, Nether Strike, double time. Throw in the ult as well. He's fine this time though, he has not been broken. Oh, illusion versus illusion. Maybe he gets some kind of lifesteal on the Anti-Mage. I don't know, maybe not. That looks like an assault cutass for Necrophos. Like agile AC. This is going to get turned into a rod of Atos eventually. Midas, Silver Edge, Spirit Breaker with the brown boots. I'm always like that on Spirit Breaker. I'm like, what boots do I want though? Even though movement is damage, you know, you should. What you got? Shiva's Guard. Storm Spirit, so they can finish that. And a blade mail for Abaddon, and number 2 lowest on the net worth position. Smoke, ooh, this could be fun. Ags finished up for Anti-Mage. They know those are fakes, they do not reveal. Dire's middle tower. Wow, I think that's the 5th tower those guys have denied. That's pretty good. Pretty good.
A tribute to my house.
Well, we're at 40 minutes. Net worth 21k for the Anti-Mage, 19.3k for the Storm Spirit. And then it's... Oh, Tinker and Storm Spirit are level pegging, and then after that it's Ember Spirit. So Ember perhaps not farming quite as fast as he'd like. Does go for crit build next, and we'll find his level 25 soon, which... I wonder what he takes. Smoke of Deceit called out by Lich. And an Invis rune as well. This could be pretty big. Scan goes out there on Roshan. This is actually huge. Here we go, boys. In comes the Zip. Throws it down. Bursts 9 up immediately. His ult has been popped. There's a bit of a roll around by Dolly, but he's came outside of the pit. That's kind of bad. You want him in the pit for the fight. The Lich ult doesn't really do much. Ice Dolly. Can I get caught? Nope. There comes the Ember to clean up those Slardar. Level 22. I hear ult from Necro. Oh, Storm looking for a way out. Won't find it. Oh, triple down for 2. 4 for 2. No, Dire, what are you doing? They had all of the aces. Well, the waves are breaking against Dire's top barracks. Backdoor protection is there, so fill your boots, I guess. Here comes... Oh, well, we decided not to. Gonna go back to the Roshan. Cross of Haze. Not able to pop it to get it on, so now he needs to wait for it to come off cooldown. There it is. Oh, maybe he did pop it. No, he did. I guess he did with her. Boom. So, I mean, this should be Rax for sure. Don't see how it couldn't be.
A soldier's fortune.
Gonna farm a little bit longer, maybe, it seems. Cha-ching, 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 cha-ching.
Dire's top shrine is under
attack. Oh, that was a shrine, I see. Blade mail finished up for Abaddon. Should be a nice surprise. Now, here they go, digging deep. Gonna push this top lane. There's only two of them there. Tinker will join. Start the march of the machines. The rest of his posse, not ready yet though, it seems. The response will be immediate though from the Dire. All five of them gonna go in. They're gonna find Pangolier on his own. And now they're looking to clean up some more. And Burt gets caught out. He throws out a remnant to the side there, so he will be fine. Ult comes through from Lich. But it looks like he tried it on Anti-Mage or something. Nice bit of rocket spam. Mid lane, getting pushed in by Anti-Mage Illusions. Oh, Spirit Break is searching. Finds Abaddon. Thinks no. I can get a better kill. There's double damage bottom. I don't know if Tinker wants to fight more with the team instead of pushing lanes. I mean, obviously he's still going to split lanes, but maybe he fights more with the team. They're running out of time, I think. Stupendous. This Ember is getting pretty big. Storm is pretty big as well. Shiva's nearly finished up. Oh, Abaddon in the mid lane. There's the blade mail. Okay. Gonna heal up a fair bit. Ember Spirit. Gonna make sure it's all the way. Cool him in. Clean him up. Watch out for bottom lane creeps, guys. And also, this yellow guy keeps pushing our towers. GG, boys. Three enemies down. You're worried about two. Push. Oh, full dead list finished up for Ember Spirit. 33-43. Dire making the Radiant pay for every inch of this battlefield anyway, that's true. Hi. Sloppy pickoffs here. The Radiant just having to think on a different level, a whole different level, if they want to not just get picked out like this. Oh, Spirit Breaker.
Dire's top barracks.
What? Alright, let's see how much he gets. Looks pretty good so far, that's like 60, right? He got like 100 hit points. With his illusions. Decent. Decent. He won't get nearly as much this time. Alright, another 100. Oh, the blink is there, he's looking. Abyssal Blade doesn't find him, Silence is returned though. Looks like they might stay together though and push. Meanwhile, bottom tower. Oh, this tower is down. No deny either. Alright. Alright. Come on, Auntie Magi. Here comes Tinkerini. Aegis will expire. By the way, he had Aegis this whole time. He could have gone in and... Tinker caught out though. In comes Anti-Mage, but there's not much you can do. They're just going to zip out. Poggy going to zip out, and that's quite a big pickup. Tinker going to come straight back. In comes Anti-Mage with a big mana void though, and he does find one. There's two. The blade mill's out on nine now as well. And Ultimo looking in the woods to try and hide, but Dolly finding him with the swashbuckle. Just kidding. Nether strike into Dagon to finish him off. Oh, they missed the Ember, but the cheeky basher hits from Anti-Mage. Here comes Storm Spirit, full health, going to clean up somewhat, does kill the Tinker. Stun comes through though from Slardar. Down goes Poggy, and this is a problem. Down go the Rax as well. They're trying to get out, and Ember probably going to get some cleanup kills here. Well, it's 3-4-4. Where is the zip? I see mid. Oh, Anti-Mage going to town here. And Storm Spirit needs to be careful. Anti-Mage has Abyssal. They're going to take both sets of rocks. This is unbelievable. Why are they letting him do this? We will never know. Maybe they just think he's too strong to fuck with right now. Illusion's doing work. Abyssal? No Abyssal. Chains. They found the wrong one. The vortex. He pulls him in with his own vortex. Rocks taken. And now he's going to work on the bottom tower. Is about to flounder. He's rooted. Starts taking some damage. Decides to back out. Oh, they're looking for him though. Oh no, they smoked right next to him. Manta's out. Blinks. Regen rune, delighted to find that. He does have a Lincoln's, not much he can do. Ends up abyssaling himself, is that right? Yep. Oh, he charges. What? Oh, is the charge coming from green? No. Well, he'll get the necro. I'm not sure they can get this guy though. That's a much more difficult kill, but there will be a bash. He charges back towards the storm, towards the Spirit Breaker, who should be on his way, but cancels it. Alright, he goes. He's going to push up here, starting on this tower. There is a buyback available for the Ember Spirit. He should probably use it. He's not going to get much other chance if he doesn't use it now. Maybe he really wants a gold though. Blink forward from Octork into the stun. Down goes the Spirit Breaker. Zip in from Poggy. He's going to work. There's a BKB on this Slardar though. And Wobris. Oh, I'm just kind of throwing out some damage. Mana Styles out for clear. In comes a roll from the Pangolier. Does catch one. Oh, Tinker getting wrecked on the background by the Spirit Breaker. Slardar goes down now as well. Where is Anti-Mage? Still no work done on the tower. A good hold then for the Dire. It's 2-2, but they managed to push them back. Pangolier, it's 3-2. Oh, the stuns. No, the Abyssal Blade comes in. He should be fine. He can't zip away though. He doesn't have the mana for it. Chains will save him though. Chains save up the Storm Spirit. It's all good in the hood. We're at 51 minutes and 46 seconds. 33k on this Anti-Mage. 10k advantage. Two sets of racks up for the Radiant.
knocked out. Dire's bottom shrine is under attack.
Well, Claire, I guess, just looking for this regenerating top with this history and bottom into an Aegis. She isn't up yet, 56 seconds. Then, high ground push. Dire actually making aggressive movements out of the way, out of the jungle. Hi! You thought you could just roam around in my woods? No. Do pop us all. He should start TPing immediately, decides not to. In comes the storm with a little bit more death for Abaddon. Abaddon easily taken out. No big deal there. Tinker still with the split push build. It's working so far. Why change it if it ain't broke? Oh, Hurricane Pike, he's so fast. Does have the Lotus Orb. In he comes with the Abyssal Storm Spirit as well, though. Silence. Oh, Oct Orc, by the way, is here with a cheeky blink stun. Down goes the Necrophos. Clear, looking for... Oh, this is a hardcore push up now from the Radiant side. They should go up onto the high ground, get the tower. CMZ is forward already, tossing out rockets. Ember does a little bit of work, but the stun is there on CMZ. And a zip in. Gonna get CMZ and the Pangolier with one zip, basically. Anti-Mage struggles. His manta has already been used. He needs to blink out, but he's in a lot of trouble. This Ember has Lincolns, so that's a dead Anti-Mage, surely. Yeah. Yep. Got him.
Dire's middle tower is
got him. Got him. Speed Sladar. Sladar. Zip zap. Oh, hi, Octark. Mr. Cheese and Roche. Wait. What? The Chrysophase only does minus how much? Armor reduction minus 20. Oh, minus. Two is what he actually has, I see. Meanwhile, in the bottom lane, the Dire are attacking the Radiant Tower. Taking a beating, but these guys aren't really tower pushers as such. AM saving his buyback. In comes Pangolier with the rolling stun. Finds two. Is he able to find another one? No. He will zip away. Slardar in big trouble. They throw out the Dagon and just hopeful that his BKB would drop. Three rockets come through from the Tinker. That's another one. A bit more damage. Has the mini stun talent, obviously. Pangolier gonna get the opportunity. No, he decides not to. He decides not to deny it after all. He is half health, they are aware, so they know what the plan is. Oh, but do they know what the plan is? Do they think they're gonna go this quick? Oh, they do. Okay, in he comes. Starts to go to work. The charge on Pangolier is already coming through. There is an invis rune there, though. If he throws out the shield, no shield from Abaddon to save him. The invis actually goes the way of Autonomo. Abaddon trying to chase. The rockets come through. Mini stun. Blinks forward. For something to pop the Slardar finds him, but Anti-Mage gonna fall. That's actually a disastrous situation right now. He still has buyback, but this time he may need to use its stun on three from Sladar. Where did he go? Right up the back here. Oh my god, they found him. Here comes the charge. There won't be an escape like there was last time. They will see every movement he makes now while he is getting charged. Free Roshan, guys. Free Roshan. And this could be the game. They may just have thrown away their beautiful win, the Radiant. Now we see a Divine Rapier and Cheese. Obviously Storm Spirit, best Rosh Carrier, Roshan, Aegis Carrier in the game. Coming back with full HP and mana is amazing. Oh, he is going to find the creep, but he blinks over. Gonna have to be careful, CMZ. If they find you, it's definitely over for you. Over for the whole team. And Poggy is like, no, I'm just gonna go in, man. Here I come, zip. Doesn't find him. Look at all of these little static remnants, though.
Radiant's middle tower can't handle this deluge.
Oh, Divine Rapier, be careful, Mr. Rapier. Chains, charge comes through. Gonna have to blink out of all this rocket spam. Oh, Pangolier! It's game over, boys. It's game over. Anti-Mage does get back and they instantly blow him up. Here comes Storm Spirit with all his mana, though. Zips in. Zips out. Managed to get 9 on the backside with a little cheeky sleight of fist. Down for 82 seconds. He's not bought back yet. He's not realized. Doesn't realize how important he is. Down goes the Spirit Breaker, though. That's a gracious save. And Opt Orc trying to go to work. Pops a BKB. 9 is back up. There goes his ult. Blade Mail. And an Ags. Vortex on 3 from Anti-Mage there. Throw out the ult from Necro. It wasn't enough, but that will be enough. The crit's coming through. 2 crits. This is it. The buyback from Anti-Mage. Somehow. 9. It's snowballed. They've just lost it, man. This is it. This is it. They're not even bothering. They realize. They're like, come on then, Anti-Mage, you want a piece of us? Let's go. While they're pushing tier 4s. It's down for 24 seconds on the Pangolier. Down for 52 seconds on the Tinker. It's down for this Ancient, basically. Anti-Mage. Buys back, but decides not to do anything about it. Well, Radiant had a significant lead for most of the game, and then when an Anti-Mage could have pushed so much earlier and they could have finished so much earlier, but the team just didn't want to push with them sometimes. And then to top it all off, as they were going for high ground, instead of backing up and getting that Aegis, Roshan, Cheese situation sorted, they instead got ganked in that. Well, they were trying to get it sorted, I suppose, but they went about it poorly, no wards to scout out, maybe take down a couple of dudes before you go in, just so that it's safer to do that. And they scout it out, they come in, they blow them up, and they get the Aegis and Cheese, and also all the buybacks. And it's game over. Anyway, I am General Jeevicus. I hope you enjoyed this match. I will show you guys the stats. 44-66, 59 minutes, 47 seconds. I like hero damage. 62k on CMZ with a rocket spam. And 71k on the Ember with the rapier. 66k on Poggy the Storm Spirit. I am General Jeevicus. And thank you for listening to the cast. Ta-ta.